Hello viewers, welcome to our Good Morning Tarot. Okay, we are starting the day already. Now that I am reading it, the sun has not yet risen. But I'm very much awake already. Well, this is a general reading, so it's open to all signs. So just take what resonates with you. At the same time, it is timeless, so anytime you find yourself watching this video, that's the best time for you to see it. Maybe there is a message for you regarding your present state in your present journey, in your life's journey. Okay, your present situation in your life's journey. So we'll start by trying to see what is the energy for today. Okay, the main energy for today is the Seven of Pentacles. Okay, things are going well. Whatever you started on working on, things are going well. By the way, right now is already we are entering the new moon, the first quarter moon in Gemini. So half of the cycle is already before us, before the full we reach the full moon. So we already half of the cycle is already occurred. So somehow you have already an idea of how things will unfold itself for this cycle of the moon. And so it's a time for us to review it. In a certain sense, this card somehow resonates also that cycle of the moon, wherein this person is trying to assess what has already occurred. He is looking right now at the vegetables that he planted in the garden. Right now, things are going well. When you look at him, his vegetable has already grown, and there are already fruits coming out of the vegetable in his garden. And he continues to till it, to maintain it. He's nurturing the plant that he has initially planted in the garden, and now it is blooming. It's like after giving it some tender, loving care, now it is giving forth fruits. Now, this person is maybe reassessing, okay, what will I do next? Okay, what should I do with the fruit? How much will I cook for myself or for my family? And do I have enough in order to sell also? To share also with my neighbors, so something like that. So in a certain sense, you are right now, whatever project you started at the start of the cycle of the moon, it is now bearing fruit. And now you are already in a position to decide what to do with the fruits that have come up with all your efforts. You know that this fruit benefits you. In a certain sense, you can enjoy the benefits of this. And at the same time, you can share it also with your loved ones. And also, you can share it also to other people around you. You can freely give it to them. And also, at the same time, you can also sell your products, sell them as products. So, right now is a time for you to take a pause and try to make decision of the things that are already here. So, for some of you, you might choose to decide already at this time what to do with the fruits of all your labor. Now, at the same time, you know what I'm thinking of right now while he is looking at the fruits? He feels a little bit sleepy. Yeah, because I think you are right now at the time wherein you just need to wait and see. Okay, for some of you, maybe you are at that point of waiting and seeing. It's after you've done your part, you've prepared the ground, you've done the preliminaries. Now it's time for the universe to work on what you have planted. It's like after the farmer has planted everything and the farmer just maintains the land to make sure that what he has planted will continue to grow. So he just sort of like maintaining only the land. He is more now in the less active role. You just allow the universe to make it unfold. As you rest in your as you take a rest for a while now, the universe is taking care of what you have planted. While you are out of the field, gradually the plant is growing. So right now, it's as if the momentum has already started and you just have to be in the less active role and you are just letting the situation unfold itself. So in a certain sense, maybe for some of you, you lack the activity that you used to have. Okay, so in a certain sense, maybe you say, for some of you, maybe you are longing for more activities, for more action. So for some of you, maybe you are considering of starting a new project, or maybe trying to create something new. Well, it's good. It's good. Just as long as it's up to you to decide whether you will continue on this project or maybe you will start something new. Since this one is already rolling on its own, it's already evolving on its own, you can continue this, and all you have to do is to just nurture it every once in a while just to make sure that this project grows, and you can already start a new endeavor so that you won't feel sleepy. You will be inspired to continue. So it's like you created something and now you are inspired to create something new. So you continue on creating them, but at the same time, maybe there is a need for you to just constantly, every once in a while, nurture what you already started, because it's already bearing fruit and it's not benefiting only you but also the people around you. So in a certain sense, we also have that responsibility to continue taking care of what we have. Or if we want to really completely go to another endeavor, to make sure that we entrust it to somebody who has somehow a similar passion to the passion that you had, so that what you have started will continue to give benefit to the people around you, give benefit to the universe. So in a certain way, this is already a legacy, your legacy to the world. You can entrust it to somebody to continue it, or you can continue nurturing it while you start other endeavors. So you can just, you don't have to exert too much effort on this one. You just maintain it, maybe improve on it, maybe continue to be creative so that you will continue to have that energy. You will not feel sleepy. At the same time, you can create other things. Since this one is already unfolding on its own, all you have to do is to nurture it every once in a while. This is already a gift to the universe, and it can be a stepping stone or an inspiration for you to create more things for the benefit not only of yourself, not only for your loved ones, but also for the other people who are around you and who are destined to benefit from this. So this is already a big achievement. It's up to you to nurture it, or maybe to entrust it to somebody who will nurture it further. Or you can continue upon this path. As you continue upon this path, you can still continue on creating newer things. So just take it the way it resonates with you. Okay, now for some of you, you at this time where you are a little bit more stable, somehow you are feeling that there are certain things here, there are certain aspects here that no longer satisfy you. Well, maybe while you were doing this project, while you were making it grow, you might have discovered certain aspects there that does not satisfy you. So it's time for you to, you know how it is, weeding out after you planted a seed. Together with the plant that grew, there are some weeds along the path. Okay, now for your project to continue to be healthy, for your project to continue to grow, you need to remove the weeds. Maybe this is also the reason why this person is looking at the garden. Maybe he was saying, oh, the plant is growing, but there are some weeds along the path. Okay, I think I need to remove them. So he was thinking of that way. So it's the same here also. Maybe as this plant starts to grow, whatever this project is, maybe you need to do some weeding out, okay? Removing those things that by this time half of it is you're halfway through, you already see the things that are helping the growth of the plant, and you already see also those things that might be potential competitors to the growth of this plant, like weeds and everything like that. So somehow you already know them and you are looking at them objectively, just as this person is looking at them objectively. He is in deep thought, just as this one is in deep thought. So somehow you, because of your experience in the first, in the from the new moon to the first quarter moon, you already know those things that will not be beneficial in this endeavor. So it's time for you maybe to weed them out, so that this gift that you received from the universe will continue to flourish. Now, it can be that from this one, a new inspiration might grow, and this can be the new cup that is being offered. Somehow you distance yourself already with the cup. Maybe it's because, yes, you don't need to give as much attention to it as it was before. All you have to do is to maintain it and to nurture it, and maybe to weed out those things that no longer serve you. So if you weed them out, then the plant will continue to grow and continue to be healthy, and you can open yourself up to new possibilities. And you can always entrust this to somebody else as you continue. The best way is to train somebody who also has the same passion as you have, so that they can continue this one, and maybe they can even contribute for it, their ideas into it, their passion into it, so that it will continue to grow and benefit a lot of people around you. So in a certain sense, yeah, it's time for you also to reassess the situation and to weed out those things that no longer help the progress of this new project, of this project that is about to reach its full moon. Okay, now let us try to see what is the advice of the universe for you at this time. Well, if for example, for some of you, you want to move on to something new, well, just entrust it to somebody. Here, you see here, in the Eight of Cups, the person is walking away, but everything is in order. The cups that he left behind are in order. So if you are inspired to do something new because you already succeeded and things are going well, maybe entrust it to somebody who will continue to take care of these things, because this is already benefiting not only you but other people. So to continue for it, to transform it into a legacy, something that will continue to benefit other people, maybe you need to entrust it. If you decide to choose another path, try to get your affairs in order. Try to make sure that this legacy will continue to live on. Entrust it to somebody who can be passionate just as you have been passionate, so that this can become a legacy, something that will continue to benefit others, even if you are already no longer in the picture. So before you walk away, if you are inspired to follow this new inspiration that the universe is giving you right now, set your affairs in order and trust it to somebody who will continue the legacy. There's a reason why you were inspired to start this one. Now, if you are inspired to do something else, everything that you've done that is already benefiting other people, entrust it to people so that it will continue to help others. So whatever you have started, try to, if you are inspired to do something else, try to make sure that it will continue to benefit people. So here in the Eight of Cups, the person before he walked away, he had everything in order. He made sure that things are in order before he started walking away. So somehow it's like the universe telling you, this is already something that benefits the world. It can be your legacy. So if you decide to follow the new inspiration, entrust it to somebody or get things in order. And maybe if you still would like to continue this one, just nurture it. Just nurture it and go on to another endeavor. Make sure that it will continue to benefit others. Now, there is a new adventure, a new mystery that awaits you. well, new creative things is on the offing. I think, yeah, this is a learning process and a new lesson is coming before you. You are growing, you are evolving. But yeah, make sure that what you leave behind will continue to benefit other people. So this is what we have for you for today in our Good Morning Tarot. We go to the second part, which is the self-care tip. Okay, for our self-care tip for today, it's interesting. It says here, it's from Thich Nhat Hanh. Okay, it says here, if monks and nuns do not cherish their time of practice, they will have nothing to offer the world. And then below it, it says, find peace in your extraordinary efforts. Your work is not in vain. Some of us are called to make a difference in the world, especially those who are light workers, those who have consecrated their life, who have chosen to remain unattached to anybody so that they can embrace the world even more. They could love the world even more. They give service unconditionally, and it often requires a lot of sacrifice. It's the same for us. I mean, even if you are committed to people, you give love unconditionally at certain points and certain moments in our life. You give sacrifices. For example, if you chose to be married, you care for the people that the Lord or the Divine has entrusted into you. It can be your life partner. It can be the children that is the fruit of the love between you and your life partner. This requires dedication. This requires sacrifices on your part in order to nurture them to be the children or the people that you wish they would become. Somehow you allow them also to, you nurture them to allow them to be the person that they are meant to be also. So you give them also the freedom to evolve to what the Divine has designed them to be in this lifetime. So in a certain sense, when you give yourself in service, whether it be to your loved ones or to the world, if you are called to be a light worker and you are called to remain single so that you can be of better service to the world, sometimes we come to a point in our journey when we feel, is all this effort worth it? Or have I just given all my energies, all my love, all my life and all my time, have I given it in vain? Well, the card tells us, your work is not in vain. The song that you sang is your legacy to the world. This is your gift to the world. And sometimes you just don't know that it's making a difference, but it's already making a difference. It's making a difference to the people that you have encountered. Sometimes these people, you might not be even aware that it has touched their lives. But it has touched their lives. Because all of us were placed into this dimension, into this lifetime, because we have a special song to sing. And once you start singing that song, it's going to touch lives. It's going to change the universe. It is like a drop that is falling in a very still pond. It will create ripples that will touch not only the people around you, but in an indirect way, it will touch the whole universe. It changes the universe. Your existence has changed the universe, and it continues to change the universe. It continues to evolve. It continues to take part in that concert of the cosmos. So in a certain sense, everything that you've done, they are not in vain. They continue to change the world around us. The important thing is to choose a path with a heart and to love as best as we could, and to marvel at the journey that unfolds before us. So take heart, don't lose hope, don't lose your inspiration. Just keep on going, keep on making a difference, and believe that what you are doing is changing the world, is changing the cosmos, and is changing lives. Now, let us try to read from the handbook that accompanies this card and gain more insights from it. Now, with the regards to internal self-care, which is related to our mental, emotional, physical, and let's include spiritual health. Let's read from this part. It says here, our commitment to our goals, both internal and external, can both feed us and leave us feeling exhausted. So it can enrich us, but at the same time also it can drain us sometimes. Okay. Are you energized by what you are working on, or do your thoughts seek unhealthy patterns? Are your feelings helping to clarify meaning in your life, or muddying the waters? Does your body feel strong and well, or stressed and broken? Today, reflect upon the goals you have been striving toward over the past 6 months. How have you internalized the process of working toward them in your thoughts, feelings, and physical body? What might you shift to make the process of moving toward your desires more deeply pleasurable? Okay, so it seems like we are being invited to take a pause and try to see, are the endeavors we are dedicating ourselves right now energizing us or depleting us of our energies? If it's depleting us of our energies, then maybe there are some adjustments that we need to take. For example, if the cistern is leaking, then try to look for the hole, okay, and try to seal that hole so that it will not leak anymore. At the same time, if we feel drained, maybe the source that we are taking our energy from is not that unlimited source, which is the divine. Because if the divine is the source of our inspiration and the source of our energy, we will always be a cup that is overflowing. So let us try to see also what are the things we rely on to fill up our cup. If it is not the divine, then maybe we need to shift to another, to the source, to shift to that unlimited source, which is making the divine as the source of our happiness. And when we reach out to other relationship, it is because we would like to share the fullness of our life to them. And we do not expect them to fill up our cup. If we are already relying on others to fill up our cup, then maybe we need to make some fine-tuning and redirect it again to the unlimited source, which is the divine. And let our overflowing cup help us to celebrate with these people that we are journeying with. It makes us not attached to these people so that they can freely come and go. They will feel happy with the relationship that we have with them. And we also will continue to have unlimited source of happiness because we are not attached to certain people with regards to finding our happiness. Now let's go to the external self-care, which is related to relational, community, our creativity, and our work. Okay. Reflect on an area of life where you feel you are putting tremendous effort right now in order to achieve a goal. It could be in work, in a relationship, or in your personal development. Now imagine this process existing just as it is, but take away the end point. There is no goal, only practice. How does this perspective change how you feel? Would you change anything about what you are doing if there was no price at the end of the process? Achievement is often illusory because once we attain one goal, we set our sights on to the next. The true meaning of our lives comes from the effort we put in and the practices we keep. You are not your goal. You are your process. Now, this is very interesting. It's enjoying the journey instead of being concentrated on the goal. The goal is there. You are aware of the goal. But you are enjoying the journey. You are enjoying the process. Sometimes we are so fixed towards the goal that we no longer enjoy the journey. We just keep on reaching for the goal. And once you reach the goal, you reach for another goal. So it's like time passes, our life passes, and before we realize we have not lived our life or enjoyed the process of living. So we need to enjoy the process. It's like choose a path with the heart, and as you journey through that path, enjoy it breathlessly, living the present moment, seizing the day. I guess it is related to our tarot reading earlier, wherein you started a project and then you came to a point wherein you are inspired to do something else, something new. Well, the question is, did you enjoy the journey? Or you are rushing again to another one? Okay, the important thing is, yes, we enjoyed the journey. And at the same time, to always remember, what you already created is your legacy already. So we need to take care also of that legacy to make sure that as we go to the new chapter, as we open the new chapter, we don't leave behind the legacy that you already have created. If there is still a need for you to nurture it, you take good care of it, or you entrust it to somebody who will continue the legacy. So in a certain sense, whatever you already accomplish, it's already a gift to the universe. It's either you nurture it every once in a while, you don't have to exert too much effort on it, or you entrust it to somebody who will continue that legacy. So enjoy the journey. Take time to pause and smell the flowers. Take time to sit down and watch the changing colors of a sunset. Take time to sit down and listen to the stories of a friend or a loved one. So that's it for today. I hope that this Good Morning Tarot has helped you in your present journey. I hope you resonated with the readings. And thank you for the likes and comments you've given to the channel. Thank you for subscribing. I hope to see you again next time. Until that moment, may God continue to bless your ways.